The fun and ridiculousness continues in this edition of Plus Minus. Now, if you have not seen this segment before, it's very simple. It's just a hockey spin on true or false. True being plus, false being minus. Let's play, shall we? It's got a bit of a referee theme to some of these.
Not today. No way, Kemosabe.
I can't patrol these two. I need to be a referee over here, okay? Anyway, let's start with Zach Hyman, right? He has the hat trick delayed. They didn't give it to him until much later in the game. And then the hats went on the ice. He got a lot of them, including a cowboy hat, as we saw, including a foam finger, which is not a hat. So that's a separate conversation. But the plus minus here question is, are you a plus or a minus throwing hats on a delayed hat trick? Yes or no?
Plus
minus.
Plus.
Why?
Because he got a hat trick in the NHL.
But it's so delayed. Like, the moment is past. I feel like I'm a minus.
How are you going to control them? They're at home. You know that Canadian beer is like moonshine?
Yeah, sure is. Molson's.
So, yeah, they're getting after it.
Yep, 8%.
They hear hat trick.
I'm not saying, like, it shouldn't happen, but I'm saying, I would not be doing it.
Spend hundreds of dollars to go to the game and throw their $40, $50 hats on the ice to celebrate their team. Yeah. Let them do it. Let the people live.
Plus on the foam finger, too, because that's not going to hurt anybody, and you want to throw stuff on the ice.
Just chuck it.
We're celebrating Zach Hyman.
Foam
trick. What other sport can you throw things on the ice in the middle of a game?
Oh, my gosh. Not many. Not any I can think
17th hole at TPC Scottsdale.
That's true.
Waste management, open or whatever. There's probably something.
And that's electric.
Okay.
That's a loophole.
Joffrey, so you guys are plus. Loophole. Even on delay,
this crowd's going to be electric. You guys are late with that one.
We are off the rails today so hard. I am a minus. I think if the moment's passed, it's passed. Move on. I honestly wonder if that's why people threw their hats then later for Connor Brown. I mean, there were so many hats being thrown. What happened?
Mayhem.
I think
it's like when they review a goal and then they call it a good goal and they blast the horn again because people just want to hear that horn. Yeah, exactly.
Or in Columbus.
Yeah, cannon. Ooh.
That scares me.
Remember?
Though.
Nightmares. It would always scare me coming on the ice.
0.
Yeah, we win.
Next question.
Oh, okay, next question. Referees having cheering sections. Did you see this last night in St. Louis? Yeah, it's a real thing. And we know there are some lovely refs out there. They do a great job. And so anytime they get involved, they've got people cheering them on. So plus, minus. You like it, you hate it.
I know how Brian feels about referees in general. I'm a plus. I mean, people always say that nobody...
That doesn't surprise me.
People always say that nobody came here to watch the refs. Those people came to watch the refs.
They clearly did. They dressed up to watch the refs.
And refs are people, too. So why can't they be cheered for? All they get is negativity. Let's make them feel good once in a while here, hey?
What happens when they give a terrible call, though, against the team that you love? I mean, are you still cheering for them?
I mean, they should probably boo it then. Like, if your team doesn't do well, you boo. The refs don't do well, you're there to support them, you boo. Yeah.
I mean, if you're cheering for the refs, it doesn't matter. Like, they can do no wrong.
Okay.
I have a great respect for on-ice officials. Okay?
Okay.
I have great respect for on-ice officials. I have great respect for the officials that make very little money to officiate youth games and all the way up.
Yeah.
It's tremendous. We're running out of them because of all the wrong reasons. So officials are very important. I have tremendous respect for them. There's a but. That are a little power trippy, but that's in the younger age group. Now, the refs at the NHL are the best in the world at what they do, okay? But they weren't good enough to play. So we're not going to spend money to go watch the refs. And they'll tell you that, too. And I like a lot of them. I don't like all of them. And the ones I don't like probably know. But I like a lot of them. And they weren't good enough. They weren't good enough to play. Sorry, we're not going to go cheer for you.
Yet here they're in their 40s, still in the NHL.
Skating around without what? A stick or pads, and they're only allowed to touch the puck with their hand, which is illegal.
But so you're not, are against
ever,
them
ever,
having...
Never,
I don't get
it. Yes, I'm against it.
I don't get the logic here.
Huge minus. 2-1. What was your call? We'll see what your...
I think it's a minus two.
Oh, geez.
All right, 2-1. You guys are in tie for second right now. Corey, people going to cheer on the refs at a game?
Who cares? It's fun. Bunch of Scrooges over here.
I think there are a lot more creative ways to get dressed up for a hockey game than that.
Get out of here.
They're trying to be funny. They don't care about the refs.
Some people do, apparently.
Apparently.
They don't.
I think it's a sham. I think it's a way
Travis
to get on camera.
Sham mockery.
I think it's a way to get on camera.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, anyway, sorry. I'm going to have St. Louis fans coming at me. Let's move on. Speaking of refs, we had a good moment, too. We've said that they're showing a little more personality this year, yeah, right? So did you get this moment last night in Vancouver? Check it out with Quinn Hughes.
Nichushkin in the neutral zone was run into by the star defenseman, so we'll go 4-on-4 for 53 seconds.
Go to the box, please. Go to the box, please. Now. Vancouver penalty, 43, 2-minute minor interference.
But Dad, but Mom, that's how I could hear Quinn Hughes basically saying that. It was such a
look. What a nice, kind of
full marks.
What a nice guy.
Full marks.
We should not celebrate him, though. We should not cheer for him for that, for being very calm, very polite.
No, you should go to an NHL game and cheer for the refs. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Don't tell that to me. Tell that to the people in the crowd. I didn't dress up like a ref.
You just endorsed it.
I said it was fine.
Put your stamp on it.
I said it was fine.
He said, let the people live. Let the people
live. I don't ever see more of that. I just don't have a problem with
that. That's what you're saying.
That's going to ruin your day. That's your problem.
It's not going to ruin my day. I think it's dumb.
You're a live and let live kind of guy, and I appreciate that. We're bringing it back again. Oh, no.
Look at these dorks.
Wow. Fire. Boiler is on fire. I didn't know this was an addition of the
Boiler. Back to the question at hand.
Jeez.
Referee showing personality.
Yeah, yay or nay,
yay.
Plus or minus.
Yay.
Yeah.
I want to hear more from these guys.
I love
more.
That. Okay.
Yeah.
Look, that was fine, and he handled it well. He could have easily screamed at him and yelled at him, teed him up, and he was the adult in that situation.
I just thought it was.
But refs aren't human, so why do you want to hear from them anymore?
I didn't say they weren't human.
Okay.
Well, we saw a couple weeks ago what the ref say. He said, you're not going to like it, but.
And that was funny.
Two minutes for hooking. It was funny.
I'm all for that. Let's get the theatrics back in the game.
What's the football guy, Ed Hockley, isn't it?
Ed Hockley, yeah. He's gone. Like, his son's there now, though.
Oh, well, but that's, like, when you make a name for yourself, it's because.
He's got named himself because he did 5,000 push-ups.
He's got guns. He's got weapons this way.
And he put his ref shirt in the dryer for 3 hours, and then he went out on Sunday.
Yeah. I just think, like, in everything, right? Yeah. At the end of the day, this is an entertainment business.
Yeah.
We're here to get people to watch and be entertained. And
are you not
entertained? Why are you not entertained? Why not have the refs have a little personality? I think it's great.
I'm in. Any Gladiator reference?
We are plus on that. Just no cheering sections, please.
We have any more?
Okay. We do have one more. This has nothing to do with refs. This is actually still very much a mystery to us. The Pittsburgh Penguins announced today that the shipment carrying the Jaeger bobbleheads for tonight's game has been stolen en route to Pittsburgh. As a result, the bobbleheads will not be distributed at tonight's game, but will be distributed at a later
date. Christmas is canceled
in Pittsburgh. And then this, check it out.
Buckle up, baby. Let's go find your friends.
I mean, there's a lot of questions I have, but my big question here for the purposes of this segment is plus minus. Do you believe that they were actually stolen? Or is it the whole, like,
who
PR
would steal 30 bag lunches? Like, that's what I'm like, who's going to steal 10,000 bobbleheads? Like, what are you going to do with them?
I thought this legitimately happened.
It might have.
I'm like,
we don't
this
know.
Is the Penguins this year. They can't, nothing is true. It's just, I love my time in Pittsburgh. It's,
but honestly,
it ain't going,
like,
great.
We don't know if it was, you know, a produced thing.
So they just fast put that together.
They could have today. Jaeger's in town. He's been hanging out in Pittsburgh.
It's planned. If it's not planned, full marks. If it is planned, there's a little misdirection here to take. Like, don't
They've
look over here.
Run out of ideas.
Don't
yeah.
look at this right now.
Yeah.
Worry about this.
Poster fire over here.
So I give it a plus. I mean, a little, you know, keep your fans distracted a little bit. A little propaganda.
I give it the propaganda. I give it a plus for the ad and leaning into it if it is true. I give it a minus if it's true too, though, because.
Okay,
I give this a plus. I give this promo if they're leaning into it, be like, hey, let's do something funny with this and make it funny. That's cool.
That's awesome.
The fact that somebody might have stolen 10,000 bobbleheads is probably a minus in my
opinion. Ridiculous.
I have a question for Jamie. Which one of us do you think would drive a yellow truck?
Definitely you.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, yellow Wrangler in college.
Right. Yeah.
Yellow Wrangler had the matching yellow Nextel two-way.
And you chose that. It wasn't just like
It was nails. That thing was.
Everyone knew when Brian was driving around campus in college.
It was awesome.
Because his head stuck out the roof of the Wrangler.
Right. Well, and it was bright yellow.
And that, too.
Okay. I learned something new today.
And again, yellow Nextel two-way that matched the Jeep.
You know, the world may never know what happened to these bobbleheads, but I have a feeling we'll find out in the next few hours here.
Yogs is on the case.
He's on the case. Looks pretty serious.
Get to the choppa.
Let's go get your friends.